Hi everyone, my name is Rosemary, founder of TechAble Assistive Technology. Following the two previous videos on iPhone tips and settings for seniors, today I'd like to introduce the touch accommodation accessibility features, which can be beneficial for the senior iPhone users. This feature is also useful for people with motor skill impairments, since the feature can help using a touch screen much more comfortably and much less frustrating. So let's take a look at the feature. So touch accommodation is under settings, and then accessibility, and under physical and motor, you will see touch. So tap touch. And if you scroll down, there is touch accommodations. So tap this. And from here, you can turn on and off touch accommodations feature. So I'm going to turn it on. And let's look at hold duration first. So if you have tremors and tap the screen repeatedly, you can enable this hold duration. So you must hold an on-screen button for a certain length of time before it is activated. So I'm going to tap and turn it on. And under hold duration, you can adjust the hold duration time by tapping this minus or plus buttons. And since hold duration feature is already turned on, if I just tap this, it's not going to change the time. I have to hold this button for at least 0.2 seconds to activate either minus or plus sign. So I'm going to hold this minus button to decrease the time for at least 0.2 seconds. And you can see now it's changed to 0.15 seconds. Let me tap plus button the same way, at least 0.15 seconds to activate the plus button. And now it changed to 0.2 seconds. I'm going to turn this hold duration feature off by holding it for at least 0.2 seconds. And you can see now it's turned off. And under hold duration, you'll see ignore repeat feature. Ignore repeat feature works similar to hold duration, but using this feature can be particularly useful if you try to type a text or an email. So again, after you tap and turn it on, right below it, you can tap the plus or minus sign to increase or decrease the ignore repeat time. So currently I have it as 0.4 seconds. I can increase or decrease it, but I'm going to leave it as 0.4. And then let's go to notes. If I tap H like this, I don't know if you notice it, but if I tap it several times, it only took the first H, and any repeat within 0.4 seconds will not be considered as input. So within 0.4 seconds, it's gonna only take one input. So let me try it again with E button. So I'm going to tap E button like quickly three times, but like you can see, it only input E once. Let me try with L. So I tapped three times, but it only took one L. So like this, if I have a tremor, I tap it several times, but it only take one input within the time that I set up. Okay, let's go back to Touch accommodations. So under accessibility, touch, and touch accommodations. And I'm going to turn off, ignore repeat feature. And then let's look at tap assistance. So tap assistance is useful for the users whose fingers tend to move when they touch the screen. So you can use initial touch location if your finger tends to move
after you tap the target.
And you can use final touch location
if you cannot initially hit the target.
So I'm going to have it use initial touch location. So again, when the tap assistant is turned on, under this, you can adjust the time within which you need to lift up your finger for a tap to be recognized. So you can tap this plus minus button to adjust the time. So I'm gonna have it as 0.6 seconds. And then I'm gonna go to home screen. So my initial touch position will be taken, and I just need to lift up my finger within 0.6 seconds. So let me tap notes and open it. So like if I tap it and even slide my finger, it took my initial finger location and it still opened this app. Again, let me try to open App Store. So I'm gonna tap App Store, and even if I slightly move my finger, it's gonna take my initial finger position. Like that. Let me try one more time by opening weather app. So even if I slightly move my finger, it still took the initial finger position. Okay, let's go back to touch accommodations by going to settings, accessibility, touch accommodations. And lastly, let's look at swipe gestures feature. So with this swipe gestures feature on, you allow swipe gestures to be recognized without waiting for the hold duration time you set up on the previous window. So any of the hold duration time that you set up under touch accommodations, if this swipe features is on, then it doesn't need to wait for that hold duration time to perform the swipe gestures. And under required movement, you can increase the required movement from standard up to 8 times to prevent unintended swipe gesture. I have set it up as 8 times. So from home screen, if I swipe with small gesture, it's not gonna take swipe action like that. But if I move it further, then it's going to take that swipe gesture. So like this. But if I do this or this, it's not gonna take it.
Okay, that's all I have for today. Thank you for watching.